So I met Jed at the end of 2018. He was actually the youth leader at the youth group I was going to at the time.
You know, training, teaching, gathering, just loving people, welcoming people, reaching out, going out.
I briefly mentioned how I was into video. You know, at the time I was working with some YouTube channels and stuff like that. Eventually we got in touch because they needed somebody to do video for them for this business they wanted to start called Acrylic University. Actually at the time, I don't even think it was called Acrylic University. I don't think it had a name. I just think that Jed wanted to teach people how to paint in acrylics. He had this passion that he wanted to pursue. So the original team was me, Jed, Renee, and Dan Erickson. And Dan took care of most of the website stuff for us. He built this website basically from the ground up for us on WordPress.
Yeah, I know what you're saying. Like if we went through and we said, and we kind of talked about the courses themselves. Mm-hmm.
Now the first course that we ever filmed was Acrylic 101. It was an introductory crash course on acrylic paints. We really had no idea what we were doing. You know, we sent out that first draft of Acrylic 101 thinking to ourselves, we did a good job. You know, we're not gonna change anything based off of the feedback. I'm sure we covered all our bases. There's no way that they're gonna give us feedback that will need to make us change the course or anything like that. And we could not have been more wrong. The amount of things that we neglected in the first version of Acrylic 101 is insane. So we ended up reshooting it one or two more times after that.
Hello. It's midnight. We're in the studio still recording. We're gonna be here for another couple hours probably.
We worked so hard that year. There were so many late nights. We were so, so tired. But it was worth it. We did it. We completed Acrylic 101.
So I joined Acrylic University in late 2018, and we didn't actually launch until late 2019. It was like summer 2019. And so we spent most of 2019 just preparing content for the launch of the site, as well as getting a trailer shot for Acrylic University, because originally we had this huge idea for Acrylic University that it was gonna be this thing where we would travel all over the place and we would film painting lessons on location. You know, originally we had an idea of Jed like painting on top of a mountaintop, you know. And so later in the year we traveled to San Francisco and we spent 3 or 4 days there.
Hey friends, welcome to Acrylic University in San Francisco.
And basically our goal in San Francisco was to create a trailer for Acrylic University. And you know, looking back on it, it was a really well-made video in my opinion. Like I think we did a really good job planning it and filming it, and it looks really nice, but it didn't really do a good job explaining to people what we were about or how we could help you. But nevertheless, we had a great time in San Francisco and we shot this gorgeous trailer that if you haven't seen it yet, you absolutely should go check it out. So we traveled to Arizona, Scottsdale, Arizona. We visited the Grand Canyon and Jed attended a workshop there in Arizona. I remember how unprepared we were for the Grand Canyon. It was freezing cold and we had brought like light jackets because we were like, you know, it's the spring. There's no way it's gonna be cold at the Grand Canyon, right?
I have never been this cold in my life.
And we were so wrong. It was frigid. We could only film for like a minute and a half at a time before we had to shove our hands in our pockets and warm our fingers up again because they were totally numb and frozen. Yeah, that's one of the main things I remember about the Grand Canyon aside from how spectacular it was.
Holy, oh my god. Whoa.
Oh my gosh.
Holy crap.
Guys, there truly are no words. It's incredible. Like, it looks amazing in the pictures, but when you get there, you can't describe it.
Crazy.
And then before we knew it, launch day was upon us.
We're going to say a prayer. He's about to launch the site, so.
June 6th, 2019. Launch day of Acrylic University after 9 months.
9 months! It's true, it's crazy. Well, let's do it, man.
Alright.
This is good. The Lord is, He is over all of this. I was overcome with this, like, sense of, okay, God, like, thank you, you know, huge thanks, huge relief. I was just, like, crying, you know, but there was also this sense of, Like, Lord, we really want this to be for you and for your glory. And so I think it's awesome that we can open it up and just start out again one more time with prayer right before we click go. So
say that again, I wasn't recording.
We're live.
I'm sending an email to my brother first thing. He said, tell me when you're live.
In late 2019, we traveled to Oregon to visit Jed's nephew, but also to film Color 101. And so we spent a lot of time in Portland and the surrounding area filming Color 101, and we also met up with two artists, Diana Shine and Amy Erickson, two incredibly talented acrylic artists.
Wow.
How long have you lived here?
20 years.
Really? In this house?
Yeah.
Whoa, really?
I know.
That's awesome.
I know.
That is so cool.
Cadmium, the Vasari cadmium orange. I only need this if I'm gonna do this.
Oh, okay.
Cause nothing makes this color.
Oh, really?
Right.
Okay.
Or like if I want a setting sun that is just a weirdly super strong setting sun color. Yeah. So I'll use that or this.
Yeah.
Some of them I only use for certain things.
You knew now that we were going to be coming with our camera.
I did not know.
Hi,
Diana.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
I'm Peter.
I'm Michael.
Nice to meet you, Michael.
Hey, I love this. This is so
beautiful.
Look at that.
That was my house on Camino.
Oh, man. That's beautiful.
Is this what you're working on right now?
Yeah. But I was saying I'm like really messing around with texture. Mm-hmm. And so I did this painting and then I painted it again with a spatula.
Oh, wow.
With a metal scraper.
Yeah.
And I think it's awesome.
Yeah, that is.
I love it.
And we actually have interviews from both of them that I don't think anyone has seen yet that we haven't released. But one of the really cool things about that trip is I remember that our trip was coming to a close, like we were leaving that day, and we didn't have enough content to finish the course.
So it's the last day of our trip. We're headed home, but on the way we're gonna stop and do some final filming that we need to get done.
We were driving home, Jed kind of took some back roads to see if maybe we could find a good location to finish the rest of our course. On total accident, we just rounded a corner, and in front of us is this huge, gorgeous mountain lake with Mount Rainier looming over it.
Oh my gosh. Dude.
And we were like, this is it. This is such a blessing. And so we got out of the car right there and we filmed the rest of the course.
Hey friends, welcome to Color 101. I want to personally thank you for all of your great questions. You gave us a lot to think about when we were planning this course. Now we're going to be outside for some of this. We're going to be in the studio for some of it. And it's going to be a lot of fun. So stay tuned. This is Color 101.
In 2019, we also started filming a vlog that was kind of like a behind the scenes of our life as a small business creating Acrylic University. And we made about 9 or 10 episodes, if I remember correctly, before we stopped doing it.
Jacked up.
I'm psyched up, I'm pumped up, I'm ready to go this year. And these are the three things. Firstly,
I gotta get my nice shoes on though. I'm telling you, we're bringing classiness, professionalism back to the art world.
Quite a good sized group, and
it's awesome.
So tomorrow, color workshop is starting here. So we're just getting ready. It's gonna be fun.
I think the last episode I ever made was right after everything shut down because of COVID.
Well, the deadly coronavirus has also started wreaking havoc.
Coronavirus cases skyrocket.
The Fed cut interest rates.
Suspended, postponed, or canceled.
Coronavirus is wreaking havoc on Wall Street.
Silver.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Silver. Mama said, don't give up. It's a little complicated. All tied up, no more love. And I'd hate to see you waiting. Had to have high, high hopes for a living. Shooting for the stars, but I couldn't make a killing. Didn't have a time, but I always had a vision. Always had high, high hopes. Had to have high, high hopes for a living. Didn't know how, but I always had a feeling. I was gonna be back.
But 2020 was a pretty big year for Acrylic University. We really started figuring out what we were doing and kind of how we were going to get Acrylic University out there, how we were going to market it and how we were going to sell it. In 2020, we started Friday Night Live, which remains one of my most favorite things that we've ever done.
So about a month ago, we started doing these Friday Night Live painting parties. Every Friday night at 6 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, Jed goes live on YouTube and he paints a painting.
All right, guys, we are live and we're excited. We're gonna be painting this beautiful, beautiful sunlit kind of scene.
At the end of the stream, he gives the painting away to somebody watching. If you haven't been to one of them yet, you should seriously come. People from all over the world show up every single week, and it's overall just an incredible time.
Basically, we would go live on Friday nights, and Jed would paint a painting live, and he would chat with people while he painted his painting. And it's funny, actually, we tried it like two or three times, and it didn't seem like people were super interested. And then one day, we just had like 1,000 people show up out of nowhere to watch Jed paint. We got a lot of encouraging comments, you know, about, I've been stuck inside because of COVID, and it's been such a blessing to see Jed paint and to interact with you all. And so we kind of stuck with it, and we haven't been doing it every Friday since, but it is a pretty regular thing here at Acrylic University. It's a staple.
Welcome, it is Friday night. Welcome to Friday Night Live.
It's Friday night!
Welcome, it is Friday Night Live, and we're glad to be together again.
I remember at another point in 2020, I think it was early 2020, we shot this video. It was another trailer, you know, kind of for Acrylic University, and it leaned into more of the emotional side of Acrylic University, like what painting could do for your emotional health.
I was 32 years old, struggling with addiction, and my marriage was crumbling. I had hurt the people closest to me. I had nowhere to turn. And on the darkest day of my life, I found myself alone, painting. I can't explain it, but something in my soul was awakened that day. Art allowed me to express what I was feeling inside, things I had no words for. It gave me time to be still and think. It was like a silent prayer. And through that deep process, something happened. Hope was reborn in me. Art changed my life. How? Because art reaches the soul. It allows you to move out of your head and into your heart. Art helps connect you as a whole person. So the question is, how would art change your life? What part of your soul would come alive? What type of art would you make? But you may ask, what if I'm not a good artist? I've never painted before. The joy of art is that it's more about the process than the product.
I remember we were in the studio that night and Jed painted this painting. that was really just a bunch of emotional brushstrokes across the canvas. And, you know, he sprayed the canvas a little bit to let the paint drip down the front of the canvas and stuff like that. But he called the painting All My Tears. Something about that has stuck with me. Just seeing Jed in front of that canvas. The painting itself really does look like tears going down the canvas. And I was going through some hard stuff at the time myself. I think that's probably why it stuck with me so much.
But 2020 was a big year for Acrylic University. We published 12 landscape modules on all kinds of different subjects, like mountains, trees, flowers, and so much more. And we're almost done with 2021, and 2021 has been even more incredible than 2020. We started the Miniature Painting Challenge, which is a full year of mini paintings. And we also started working more with Diana Shine, and she released her wonderful course, The Color of Light and Shadow. We're so excited for the future of Acrylic University, and the sky is truly the limit.